Welcome to our daily devotion. The Methodist Church of Barbados invites you to sing, pray, and worship with us as we declare God's glory and celebrate His mighty acts.
Gracious God, we bow in your awesome presence this evening with humble and thankful hearts. Lord, we acknowledge you as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Father God, you are our way maker, miracle worker, healer, provider, and promise keeper, the author and perfecter of our faith. You are light in the darkness, and we give you all the honor, the glory, and praise due you. Loving Lord, we bless, praise, and magnify your holy and matchless name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Merciful Father, loving God, this evening we confess our sins and shortcomings and seek your forgiveness. Father God, we have not loved you as we ought, and we have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. Merciful God, forgive us for our selfish and uncaring ways. Lord, we have failed you by not reaching out to the needy and disadvantaged in our midst. Forgive us the times we have caused someone to stumble, because our lights are not shining in this dark world of sin. Forgive us for our moments of ingratitude, for our shallowness of faith, for sowing discord and enmity, and for our readiness to judge and condemn others. Merciful Father, forgive us for our sins and shortcomings. Restore us to the joy of your salvation and strengthen us to do your will. Father God, we thank you for restoration and life. Thank you for the plans you have mapped out for each of us. We especially thank you, Lord, for Jesus and the hope, peace, love, joy that he has brought to all mankind. We thank you for family and friends, for blessing us with good health and strength, food, shelter, clothing, and for your tender mercies renewed to us each day. Great is your faithfulness. Lord, your loving kindness to us is everlasting. Your faithfulness and truth endure to all generations. Gracious Father, we give you thanks for this time of worship, the ministry of your word, and the one who will minister to us this evening. Indeed, Lord, we thank you for those joining us this evening from the Caribbean region and the wider world, and pray that this act of worship would be a blessing to all of us. Loving Lord, we thank you for your universal church, and for those you have called to spread scriptural holiness in this season of change. As they use their gifts and graces to uplift your church, Lord, that you bless them with love, patience, obedience, compassion, courage, and strength. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Father God, we bring the children and young people to you this evening and ask that you bless them afresh. Lord, we pray that you keep your hand upon them and grant them divine protection from the evil one as they continue to struggle with their education in this COVID environment. Father God, give strength, godly wisdom and understanding to parents and guardians so they can lead these children and young people in the way of the Lord, so that they be enabled to make wise decisions and seek you first in everything they say and do. We decree and declare, Lord, that they will not be left behind, and that no weapon formed against them shall be able to prosper. Father God, you are Jehovah Rapha, our healer. In the name of Jesus, we lift before you this evening those known to us and unknown who are sick and are ailing with their health, O God. We pray, O God, that you would anoint them with your miraculous healing balm and restore them to good health. Father God, we pray blessings over our President, Dame Sandra, our Prime Minister, Mia Amar, and all those who hold positions of authority in government, and ask that you grant them godly wisdom and direction to take our nation forward as we continue to face these challenging and uncertain times. We pray for all frontline workers in whatever capacity they work. We also pray blessings on our brothers and sisters in the Caribbean region and the wider world. Loving Lord, Jehovah Jireh, we bring the poor and disadvantaged to you and ask that you reach down and touch them at the very point of their need, and that you give hope to the hopeless and sustain them through your unfailing love. Father God, as we go through pain and suffering, may we know that you are our constant companion, shield, hiding place, defender, and deliverer. And in due season, you will bring us out a victorious people. In the name of Jesus, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen. Praise be to God.
Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Savior. Hope of nations. Savior, He can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save forever. Author of salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave.
Take me as you find. So
worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Bless You, time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Come, bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy. Worship Your holy name, Lord, I worship Your holy name. Sing like never.
The scripture reading is taken from Psalm 34. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad. O magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt His name together. I sought the Lord, and He answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. Look to Him and be radiant, so your faces shall never be ashamed. This poor soul cried and was heard by the Lord and was saved from every trouble. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear Him and delivers them. O taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are those who take refuge in Him. O fear the Lord, you His holy ones, for those who fear Him have no want. The young lions suffer want and hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. Come, O children, listen to me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. Which of you desires life and covets many days to enjoy good? Keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking deceit. Depart from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. The eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and His ears are open to their cry. The face of the Lord is against evildoers, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth. When the righteous cry for help, the Lord hears and rescues them from all their troubles. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord rescues them from them all. He keeps all their bones. Not one of them will be broken. Evil brings death to the wicked, and those who hate the righteous will be condemned. The Lord redeems the life of his servants. None of those who take refuge in him will be condemned.
I sought the Lord, and he answered me and delivered me from every fear. Those who look on him are radiant, they'll never be ashamed, they'll never be ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard me and saved me from
can see that the Lord is good. He'll give you everything. He'll give you everything.
Blessed good night, sisters and brothers. Greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus. God's blessings to everyone, and especially to all mothers whom we honor today. I trust your day was a blessing. The text this evening is taken from Psalm 34, and our main focus will be on verses 1 to 3, using the theme, Acknowledging God's Goodness. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are with us, and we praise you, dear Lord, as we continue in this act of worship. Open our hearts to hear your word, and may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. In the text read, the psalmist David is blessing and praising God for what he had done for him. And he is encouraging us all to give honor, glory, and praise to the Lord, and to magnify the Lord with him and exalt his name together. David was in a difficult situation and experienced the goodness of God. God heard his prayers and protected him, which caused him to be very grateful, and he made a vow that he would bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in his mouth. Brothers and sisters, like David, when we experience God's goodness, we must be grateful for his love, grace, and mercy, and not only for these gifts to us, but also worship and thank him for who he is. He is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, our Savior, miracle worker, healer, protector, our provider, comforter, and friend. Psalm 145 verse 3 says, Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. His greatness is unsearchable. God loves us unconditionally, and we are to trust in him. His care and compassion keep us and sustain us in difficult times of our lives. Presently, we are going through the crisis of a pandemic where there is so much loss of life, jobs, homes, income, and uncertainty. But we are being kept by the grace of God. He knows our fears and the concerns of his people. And as we continue to pray and trust God, keeping our faith and hope in Jesus, he will deliver us from this enemy. We thank God also because he is our strength, and we are encouraged to seek him and trust him. Many of us can testify that if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, we wouldn't know where we would be. Verse 19 of the text tells us, Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord rescues us from them all. Personally, I am continuing to be thankful to God and Jesus for healing my body after a long illness. I will praise him for all his goodness to me. God loves all his children and will ever be with us. He promises to be with us in every circumstance. Therefore, brothers and sisters, let us keep our faith in him and walk in his ways and in the light of his love. In the name of Jesus, amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you for your goodness, grace, and mercy, and pray that we will always be grateful to you for your loving kindness to us. We pray in the name of Jesus, our risen Lord and Savior. Amen.
I love you, Lord. been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
We thank you, O Lord, for the knowledge that there is nowhere we can go that is beyond the range of your protection, your power, and your comfort. Thank you that as partakers of the sufferings of Jesus Christ, we can rejoice in our sufferings with exceedingly great joy, knowing that at the revelation of Christ's glory, we will know him as we are known by him. We thank you for your goodness, mercy, protection, and grace, which surrounds us every moment of the day. And we pray that you will send your messengers of comfort to protect us from the evil one and bring us at last into your eternal kingdom for your praise and glory. And now, brothers and sisters, may the same God of peace, who by the blood of the eternal covenant brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, may he equip you with everything good, that you may do his will while working in us which is pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. And the people of God say, Amen.
Thank you.
thank you for being a part of our daily devotion. We trust it has been a blessing to you. Now together, let us hold fast to His word, and may it dwell in all of us richly.